This is Sam Wikisa, the Kitwe District Youth Spokesperson. And I think many have asked us to say what is your viewpoint as a spokesperson for the youth in Kitwe over the aspect of what has happened to the ECL pass at the Copper Belt University. The writing is on the wall that PF are on their way out, and this is as a result of what is happening. It's not the first time that President Ed Galungu is receiving a disappointment from the Copper Belt. It happened some few weeks and months ago in Mufrira, and actually here in Kitwe by the miners, and now it is the students at CBU. You see, the PF has failed youths in all areas. And one of the areas that they failed is the education sector. And this is why we have students not willing to accept anything to do with PF. And they've shown that frustration on the bus which the president actually donated to them at CBU. You see, that frustration is as a result of many policies in the education sector that have failed. And one of them is the issue of meal allowances. This PF government has failed to handle the meal allowances in the universities. They've failed to make sure that when students are there at CBU or any other university, they have the bursaries that are needed. At the moment, for one to acquire or to have a bursary, they have to be politically connected, or their parents should be financially sound to actually make sure that they are able to bribe somebody to get a bursary for their child. So those frustrations are the ones which are making students not to like to enjoy such donations from the PF in the form of a bus. They want donations in form of equal opportunity in the area of bursary allocation. They want donations in form of equal opportunity in the area of new allowances and so many other things. The other thing is, they've seen some of us actually graduating from CBU in both undergraduate and postgraduate schools. But what are we finding on the market? The job market is very difficult nowadays. So all those frustrations are making students to behave the way they behave. But I want to advise my colleagues, the students at CBU, the students in whichever campus, that please, let's not put our frustrations on assets, let's put that those frustrations on PF on the voting day. So our frustrations should be directed towards that voter's card. Make sure you protect it. As a student, make sure you protect that voter's card. Make sure you protect that NRC, so that when the time for voting comes, we vote out the PF government that has failed you, so that we vote out the Ed Galungu-led government. Because they failed us as graduates from CBU. Today, we are just wallowing in the streets. We don't have jobs. We thought by getting degrees, we're going to have jobs. We thought by getting master's degrees, we're going to have jobs. But where are we? We are struggling on the streets. So let's put our frustrations not on vandalizing the assets, but let's put our frustrations on vandalizing PF. Let's vandalize PF on the 12th of August. Let's move them and vote in for Bali, because Bali is our only hope as graduates. Bali is our only hope as students. Bali is our only hope for our jobs when we graduate from CBU. Bali is our only hope for opportunities in the market. When the government of HH comes in this coming August, there will be no segregation of who is politically connected. Everyone will have a better and equal chance to make it. So I'm encouraging you, all of you students out there, please don't give up. Don't give up. Do whatever you can. If it means working in a booth as a graduate for now, work in a booth, but make sure you encourage that friend of yours to keep that NRC safe, to keep that voter's card safe. And on the 12th August, let's vote for Bali because Bali is our jobs. Thank you.